Hey guys, it's Dean. I'm your multi-genre music man. Hey, this is a song I've been wanting to do for a little while. It's Johnny Cash, Hurt. I know this is a cover of Nine Inch Nails, but from what I've heard from reading what the lead singer of Nine Inch Nails wrote, he said when he originally wrote this song and sang it, he sang it as a 20-something year old person looking at a life that was coming up as a drug addict, and what bad things were going to be coming and all that in his life. And when Johnny Cash asked to do a cover of it, he decided to take it and look at it as a person who's already lived this life and is looking back over his life, that, you know, what he's done. I can't think of the lead singer's name of Nine Inch Nails, but if you want to write it down in the comments, please do. But he said that, you know, it was one of the absolute best covers he had ever heard because of what he did. He totally made it his own song and pretty much, you know, changed the whole idea of the song by making it from an older person who's already lived the life. So, without waiting anymore, here's Johnny Cash, Hurt. And I'm sorry, there will be pauses again because of YouTube. They make me pause it or I get in trouble. Get you a slap on the wrist. So here we go.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting.
You know, when I hear that line, needle tears a hole in the old familiar stain, you know, being a former addict myself, a recovering addict myself, that it shows me he lived it. You know, he knows what the pain is of having to live with addiction. It's a horrible, horrible thing to live with, and you can get help. If you're listening to me right now, you can get help. NAAA. There's many numbers you can call to get help. You just got to try to get the help. There's many hospitals or recovery centers that you can go to get help. You don't have to live the rest of your life like this.
Try to kill it all away, but I remember.
One more last thing. People think this is his house that they're in. This is actually a museum called the House of Cash, I believe it's called. It's a big museum that was set up. I don't know if it's open to the public now. I know when he was alive, it was not open to the public at all. It could be now, but back then it wasn't. And so all the things you're seeing are inside this museum. It has all his things, so his piano, his stuff inside it.
Remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend, everyone I know goes away in the
picture
end.
Of his mom on the back wall. A lot of people
and
think that's his wife.
Could have it all. My empire of dirt.
Something that happens in addiction as well. You know, you want to try to keep people away from you because you know you're going to make them hurt. You're either going to, promise to do something, you'll go somewhere, do something, and then you're going to get high and not do it. You're going to take the money that, hey, I was supposed to take you out tonight to a, you know, to a concert. I'm going to take that money and I'm going to go do something else, get high, get drunk. And that's the problem. That's why he said he's going to make someone hurt.
You stay the hell away from me here.
I wear this crown of thorns upon my liar's chair, full of broken thoughts I cannot repair. Beneath the stains of time, the feelings disappear. You are someone else. I am still right here.
I'm not 100% sure what he means by that line, but what I see, the way I see that line is that it's, you're somebody else and I'm still right here. He says everyone in his life just goes away. That's what happens to a lot of addicts. If they live, you know, I have tons of friends who have passed away. These necklaces I wear, two of them, one's a girlfriend that passed away, one's Ian Parsons, my best friend that passed away. Their ashes are in there, and their urns. You know, you lose more friends than you could ever imagine. His wife, I know at the time of this taping, she's actually in the video, so she's still alive, but this is the last video he made besides a small little video that was made in a little tiny hometown with like 20 people in it. He did that. His voice was really, really bad at that point. But this is absolutely the last official video he made. And you will see his wife in a second in the background, which she's still alive. She died 3 months before he did.
What have I become?
There she is right there.
My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end.
And there you go again. Everyone I know goes away in the end.
And you could have it all. My empire of dirt. I will let you down. If I could start again, a million miles away, I would keep myself, I would find a way.
You know, you can hear his voice getting a little rougher that point in his life, but it still was very, it still sounded very good to me. And you know, the line he says at the end about, you know, he could find, if he could find a way, he would turn back time and find a way. You know, everybody says that, you know, if I could turn back time and the very first pain doctor ever went and saw for a migraine or a broken back when I broke my back, I never would have gone. Never, ever, ever would have gone if I'd known it would have turned into an addiction. And I think that's what he kind of was thinking, that if he could have turned back time, he never would have took that first drug. So so this was, again, Johnny Cash Hurt, the official music video. Please like it, share it. If you haven't hit the bell, subscribe. Please, I'm still looking for people to put into my comments, songs that they'd like to hear me do, and I will do them for you. And I am Dean, and I hope you have a great night. Have a good night.